A very good afternoon to one and all. I am Dr. Gitanshu, convener for the IIC TMU. I extend a warm welcome to the president of the IIC, Dr. Manjula Jain. Ma'am is also the associate dean academics of TMU. Dr. Shamli Datta, ma'am, principal medical college TMU. Guest speaker for today, Professor Dipali Kamthania. Dr. Ashish Chander, president of the IIC Medical College. Dr. Anish, convener for the IIC of Medical College. And all the patrons attending the session. I take great pleasure in introducing our meritorious guest speaker for the day, Professor Dipali Kamthania. Ma'am is currently working as a professor in School of Information and Technology, VIPS, Delhi. She has more than 19 years of experience in the academics and the IT industry. Her areas of research interest include machine learning and hybrid PV systems. She has over 80 research papers to her credit, which have been presented at national and international conferences and thereafter have been published in national and international journals. She has attended and organized various guest lectures, seminars, and workshops. She has delivered technical talks and chaired various sessions at academic forums. She's an editorial board member and reviewer for various reputed journals. She has also been guiding PhD scholars and is involved in numerous research projects. She is also the recipient of various Academic Excellence Awards, Best Paper Award in the year 2019 and 20, Best Teacher Award in the year 2018 and 19, Active Participation Award in the year 2016 and 17 by the Computer Society of India. In 2013 and 14, she received an award on the significant contribution to the IT field by Institution of Engineering Technology. Now, without any further delay, I kindly request ma'am to commence the session. Over to you, Professor Dipali.
Good afternoon, everyone. I would like to thank Dr. Gitanjali for giving me again this opportunity to give a talk in the TMU. And I am thankful to Dr. Manjula, Dr. Shamla for inviting me to your organization. And I would like to thank the management of TMU for giving us the opportunity to conduct a session, orientation session for the students. Mm-hmm. So I will be starting just with the basics, what we need for the innovation development and what is innovation. I have tried to include a bit of the medical health, rather healthcare innovation into today's talk. But when I just log in into the session, then only I was aware that there will be more of medical students than IT students. Let's see, I'll try to catch up and try to provide some information to all of you. So something first, a word as it is written, innovation, development process. So let us first try to understand what innovation is, right? And see, we as an Indian, most of the time what it's happened, whenever we want to do anything, we always has a solution for it and we call it as a jugaad, right? So the temporary, but those are the temporary kind of solution. But when we talk of innovation, it is more than that, right? So today's agenda will be to have a look at the what is innovation, then what are its drivers of innovations, then how your social and institute can help facilitate you in this innovation process, different components for the innovation process, type of innovations, then how at the national level the government is trying to support innovation, and then finally some healthcare innovation. Whatever the latest our country has contributed, we'll just try to have a look at some of those. So a few definitions I have written into it. Now the first one, it says innovation is a profitable implementation of idea. So my very first word comes from, like, when we try to innovate something, so what we actually look for, we are trying to look for something that is going to benefit the society or it is going to contribute in some form. And then again, it is what? It is a long-term kind of a solution that we are trying to look for, and it is extendable and can be developed in masses, right? So this is the very first thing. And it has to be next what? The third point here says it's a process or a systematic approach where what we are actually trying to do, we are trying to improve the quality of life and produce on large scale. So this is basic when we say innovation. Now, if you look at the second point, the second point here talks a bit different. It says it's a novelty in how the value is created and distributed. I have two points to discuss now. Now, innovation is generally taken in two forms. One is a visible innovation, and another one that you have, it is an invisible innovation. Now, when I say visible innovation, now what I am trying to say by the visible innovation? Visible innovation is something that is from the user perspective, right? Something from the end user. Maybe if I just talk about a simple thing, it is something like an iPhone or a MacBook. So it is like something the end user can see, you call it as a visible innovation. And where our country is actually trying to contribute, but we don't have that much visibility when it comes to the visible innovation. But when I talk about something else, that is the invisible innovation. Now, invisible innovation is something where we are actually very well placed. So I'll try to give you an example of this in context to the IT, as I am most of the time related with the IT part. So if you look at the IT part here, so what we have here, you see here, there are a lot of R&D centers which are being opened by your all big brands, or like your IBM, you have General Electrics, you have on name any of the big partners here. So what they do, they come up with the R&D center to our country, and then what happens, they used to the employees who are working in these R&D center, they are trying to develop the products. Now when we say they are trying to develop the product, now there is another point. Now when they are developing the products here, are they developing the things for the local market? No, they are not actually developing the things for the local market. They are developing the things for your global market. It means now what is happening, though you see that something like Apple iPhone or maybe any other component that we try to see, you just look at the make where it is written and you feel that has been developed by someone, any of the Western companies there. But now, actually what is happening, most of the things, they are being developed in your Indian centers. And finally, what is the label you have is for the Western companies. So what is happening here? Now, in this context, what I'm trying to see, if you look at the innovation from the point of view, its novelty and how the value is created and distributed, then innovation is no more restricted to what we say here as visible innovation. Now what we have? We have both the thing into the picture, visible as well as the invisible innovation. And our country is very well placed if I talk in terms of the invisible innovation. Similarly, when we talk about these different R&D centers that are working, these different R&D centers, maybe they are subsidiary, they are trying to file the patent, right? When they file the patent from their Indian office or the company is trying to file, like if I take the example of IBM, IBM trying to file the patent from their US office. The number is almost same, whether the patents they are being filed from the Indian office or the patents they are being filed from their any of the US, American, Western country based office. So what is my point here? My point here is that India is contributing a lot in terms of innovation, right? So let's see with respect to this, few more things. But now, another important point here is, now when we talk about innovation, innovation is not something that is just going to come in a day. Innovation is something, it means a culture need to be set in any of the organization for the innovation. And when we talk about it, generally we have 12 major drivers that we have for the innovation. Now, first one, if you see, the first one here that I have here, it is the talent. Now, talent, when I talk, I don't talk about the talent in terms of something like the Newtons or something of that type. I am just trying to talk about an individual talent. But individual talent, again, needs what? It needs your time. It needs your determination and your alignment to a particular topic or idea that you choose. Now, next is what? It is the some kind of methods. Like, you have to evolve whatever idea you think. It's not that one day you will just say, I want to develop something, and something suddenly dramatic will come to your mind and you will develop it. No, you need to follow a process for that. Every day you have to work upon it. Then when you are, say you have an idea, now the energy here is in terms of the individual, that is his time and determination. And if you follow a systematic process here, maybe with the help of your faculty or maybe with any collaboration with someone. Now, as an individual, you can work, but when you are in a single mind, when you sit in a team, then you maybe you are able to have the good idea. But your team should not be made on the basis that he or she is your friend. Now, a good team is something, or you know, you want to actually have an innovative team, means the people who are every time trying to experiment, they are ready to take risks, and their complete involvement is there. Then only what you say, you all these things when you put together, then only what you have, you are going to have an environment for the innovation, and your organization, or you can say the system, also need to support it along with giving you the liberty. Right? It's not that if you say our college has devoted to innovation period, and in that hour it is like you have to innovate something. No. It cannot be restricted. You have to give some freedom. The organization should be ready to take the risk, and risk should not be considered as something bad. Risk, failure should be well accepted, and again the team should be motivated to put in the efforts and again give a fresh start to it. So generally we talk of the innovation as a model, which is in terms of a triangle. The first triangle shows you talent, energy and method. Then the square try to show you individual, team, target and system. And the last pentagon that you have, it try to show you the remaining engagement, risk and all this components. So together, when we say all these things put together, we are trying to look for what? We are trying to look for a environment that basically support the innovation. So like now how your organization can contribute to it, right? Or how you say the social structure that is available will contribute to it. See, you come up with an idea, you need to discuss it either with your, or you need to discuss it with your teachers, right? Now, generally you see all the innovations that comes, the innovation used to come from the IITs, NIITs. Now, but now what is happening, these IICs, the government has opened up a platforms and they are trying to make here the IIC portals that you have, and they are forcing or rather asking all the institute to conduct the IIC activities here. And your new educational policy is actually supporting with all these things. So there it comes what we say, the quality education. And we talk about what the IICs or different Tycothon or Hackathon or Ideathon. So basically what we are trying to do, the government here is trying to create an environment. Create an environment for what? Create an environment for innovation. Create an environment for the new startup to come. And these to promote these innovation, the government is working at different levels. You have a lot of your government policies which are coming up. You have a lot of your Make in India, Startup India, things are being forged. And with the help of these IICs that you have, these things are basically coming into with just the innovation, which was just restricted to what I said, IITs and NIITs. We are trying to move ahead to the concept of even the private universities and colleges. So now what institution can do apart from just giving us an environment, they can just conduct some kind of the seminars, the workshops, the ideathons, the hackathons, toycathons on the different topics that you can see here. Like we have been conducted, like I just recently be giving one of the talk on the 3D printing in the Frankfurt University in the Germany. So like similarly, like lot of data is available. So the students need to be made aware how these smarter data analytics can be provided. Like as I know, like lot of medical students are available at the moment. So medical students need to also understand that AI, data analytics, machine learning, these are actually playing a great role all in almost every domain these times. So as you say, you most of what now what is happening almost this COVID had made us understand that no more the, even the medical facilities, they are restricted to the hospitals. Like now every doctor or we can say the things are just a call away. You can just make a video conferencing. And when you are doing a video conferencing or you are a lot of data has been exchanged. So what is happening? Lot of images for any of the surgeries that need to be conducted. So what is happening? Like you have big data pool for your different, let's say disease that are there. How, what are the symptoms of it? How are different medicine reacting to it? So all these things, they can be used for the purpose of analysis. Data analytics plays a major role. Using your artificial intelligence, models or machine learning, the models, they can be developed. And these models, they can be later on used whenever a new patient is there. You can just feed in. Then X, Y, Z, these are the parameters of a particular patient. These are this, these values here. So according to this particular value, what could be the possible disease or what could be the particular thing that is affecting that person? Now, in order to have innovation, you need, there are some components, right? So for an innovation process to be into picture, we say there has to be a clear framework. There has to be ideas. You need to have the innovation goals. So now when you talk about creating a framework, then what we are trying to say, you need to have a vision. Like you need to understand, like in medical context or what I could just recollect at this moment, like there's a one company, which is, I think it is Haryana based company in Faridabad. There was one company, I think, yeah, I remember its name. That is Hindustan Syringe, right? So what they did, they understood in the COVID, they, it means very in the last year, that vaccine is going to come, right? So understanding this, what they started just analyzing that when vaccine is going to come, then almost everyone across the country or across the world is going to get vaccinated. He started with the development of the manufacturing of the syringes, right? So he had a vision that, okay, there is so much of problem is coming with the COVID. So there is going to be a vaccination for that. In advance, he started manufacturing. And at the current moment, that person is the one who is actually making, has captured 70% of the market in your syringe. So what I try to put forward here is you need to understand the customer problem. You need to be unrealistic at time, but with a vision to understand that what is the problem that is going at this moment? What is the solution towards this? How science is going to play a role to it? You watch a lot of movies, right? Those movies could again be your inspiration to solve. You see a lot of robots. Yeah, in if you talk away, there was used to be a robo who used to give medicine to the patients in your different movies here. But actually, this is the current situation. This is the reality here. So we, with time, we need to understand the problem. We need to understand how science is developing. Because if we just want to work on our traditional way, then without mentioning, it is clear that there is going to be a failure. So whenever there is an innovation, that has to be in sync. There has to, you need to understand the problems. You have to think way ahead. You have to go for that. And then maybe some of the movies and all the things that you just think that it is just unrealistic, you need to look forward for the solution for that. The second, like in context to what I say, you have a dream, like you need to have a dream. So whatever you are understanding, there is a problem, you are looking, you have a solution for that. You have to believe in your solution. Like, yeah, like your PM says, you need to see it. That is the have a vision. Believe it. You should have an affirmation for it and act on it every day, right? Then only what is happening, then you are going to definitely, you are going to have success, but you need to put your time, determination, investment into it. Now, next we say for generation of ideas, like how to innovate. Now, when we talk of innovation, now there could be two things, like long-term innovation or short-term innovation, right? So if you understand that there is some problem which is very close to you, then it means in that particular situation, you have to be fast. You have to just, you cannot just take very small steps. There you have to take a leap. You have to match again again with the technological advancement and depending on the kind of scenario. Like if I talk about the COVID, COVID is what? You have to have a solution for it. There you cannot wait for years. So what happened? Even our government, what they did, the trials were so fast. Every country was just every time trying to come up with some kind of a vaccine. Though, if you remember long previously for testing of any of the medicine, it used to take years, at least 3 to 5 years as I understand. But now within a year, we had a vaccine and that vaccine is also successful. So depending on the situation, you need to understand whether it has to be short term, long term, and match with the technology and accordingly take a long or your short steps. Then when we innovate, this is the basis. You have to find a reason to innovate, right? You need to understand you want to innovate something. Now you want to innovate something where? Do you want to innovate something to raise the life of the masses? You want to go for economic growth or business survival? Like we take an example of the business survival, right? Suppose, let me talk in IT context here. Like what happens now? You have a lot of data if you talk about the call centers. So previously what used to happen, you have the call centers and every time a person will give you a call and will ask you that do you need a loan and XYZ kind of information, right? But what is happening right now? Right now, because of the big data, we can say a lot of data has already been created for the user. So what they do, they just pick up the data from there. Already all your information is available with them. They are just trying to hit a particular person. You just have now automatic answering machines are there. They will just keep on asking. You want to know your bank details or any kind of transaction. Now you are not going every time making a call to the person who is sitting at the customer center. Now you just make a call. Some number is given to you. You just different options are being given to you and you just keep on having access to that number. And maybe at the end, you may need a human intervention or everything is just automatically. So like there is a growth, lot of data is there. And within time and in a cost-effective manner, these things need to be handled, right? So we need to first understand where actually are we looking? Why we need to innovate? Do we need to innovate in terms of the process? Because as I have already mentioned initially, that innovation is not only visible innovation, but it is also your invisible innovation. So we can have something innovation in terms of the process management, or we can have something in terms of the way a particular product is being developed and so on. I hope I am able to convey the crux to all of you. Am I audible? And
yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you. Let's see. Now, when I talk about the creations, right? So what we say, we need to innovate. Now we understand that India is already maybe not visible, but at this moment, I would say even it is visible that because of the vaccine that we have developed. So it's a big take for us to have a great visibility across the world. But maybe when we talk about the creation, you see a lot of words are being written on this slide. I want to say serendipity, like maybe it has just happened by the accident or it is just by the luck. But again, when you want to innovate, you need to always think out of the box. You don't have to work on the regular tracks and you need to look for the solutions which will make local as well as it will make the global impact. It's not something that is just being developed and it is always being used in the local kind of market. We try to look for the products which can be used across, right? Okay. Now, whenever we are trying to make any kind of things, maybe for the local, and we generally, we don't try to go for the just every time for the local kind of solution, the kind of technology or the environment that has been the government is now trying to provide to us. We try to look for a broader perspective, right? So what isolation, it means if I try to develop something, like if you already have the desktop or the mainframes that you have previously, but now what is happening? You just have the simple, like, can you imagine long back that you will just be having a laptop or a mobile device, which will just be a smaller than the size of the huge, or smaller than the size of the screen of the laptop you have. But it means what happened there, a pupil was trying to move away from the old ways. And from mainframe, you shifted to desktop. Then from desktop, you moved to your laptops. And now you just have your palm tops. Like if you just have a mobile phone, you are a doctor or you are an engineer, you are actually able to handle all the things. So that was something that was thought beyond the limitations. And it was not something that was taught working on the regular track. So at times, or most of the times, to innovate, you have to think out of the box, leave the old ways behind and think of the solutions that are far long way. Like if we, like, did anyone thought that there will be the robots who will actually be serving to all the medical patients? But actually, this is the reality these days. Now, what is happening? You have the robots in the COVID time who were actually just supplying medicine or food to the patients. So along with technology, you have to move away from the old things and try to look in the forward direction, maybe in terms of, at times, in terms of a small step or your biggest steps. Now, this is what I have been discussing throughout, that innovation is of different type. Innovation is not always the end product. Innovation could be a service, like something like we can say you have, let's say, where process innovation is something like as the call center, rather than traditional call centers, which used to be previously. Now you have 24/7 call centers and you have the bots who are automatically dialing and contacting you. Like for the marketing innovations, like marketing innovation is like the kind of when you want to sell your products here, you are no longer just depending on the kind of ads or simply dive. Now you have the digital marketing into this, which is just a new way of making the service available to the people. Now you have product and service innovation. See, now if you talk about product and service innovation, see what used to happen previously, whenever there was something related to innovation, it was always thought that innovation is something that is being done by the Western worlds. And they always used to do what now, in order, since the, we say we in less paid jobs, we have the more work can be done if you have the Indian serving for you. So what they used to do, either it used to call the Indians there, or the R&D centers started coming up in India, whether it is for medical or for other purposes, and people started contributing here. Now, generally what happened initially, they used to give the lower rung of the ladder to the Indian market. And when the product was developed, then what happened, as in was on, more and more the base was given to the Indian market for the development. But as you give the lower rung of the ladder, there are always the higher chances then the next ladder need to come into this Indian market only. So what happened? Ultimately, what happened, 70% of the things actually been developed in the country itself. And then for assembly, you say the things are being sold out. Now, if you look at in the similar context, if you look at IBM in 2003, if I would say, around they were having the 20% employees from the Indian market and Indians, and around 70% they were from your Western worlds. But 2010, they have given the last figure out, where out of let's say more than, I can say, there was 70% of the employees, they were Indians, and 30% they were Western. And after 2010, they never revealed their data. So I leave it to you whether you call IBM as an Indian company or you call IBM as the Western country or the American company. So what I am trying to put forward across you is ki we are innovating. Like if you look at the example of Boeing, in Boeing, two of the major missions, like landing in zero visibility and the zero clearance, they were again developed by the HCL. Though there was some glitches there, but it doesn't mean that we didn't contribute to it. We rethink again on it, and the framework was designed for that. So we have already been doing a lot of innovation. It's just that we are not aware in masses about these innovations because most of our contribution was toward the invisible innovations. These are the kind of business models that you can have rather than just one thing. You can have the, let's say, the structural or financial model changes, then marketing innovation, like how you are promoting it, how you are actually building the customer base, what are the pricing strategies you have. So all these things also contribute to the innovations. Like if you look at the example of the online purchasing. Now, initially, few years back, if someone will ask you to buy a mobile phone of 70,000 online, or your OnePlus for 30 or 40,000, you are not going to make that much transaction online. But what happened? Then you had the Flipkart. Gradually, with Flipkart, what you had, the trust was developed. And now what you have, actually now they Flipkart basically made the base for the online marketing. And now if you see, now you have the big player Amazon into the picture. And we all are very comfortable in buying anything online. But when it was for the first time, that was actually the innovation of bringing the things into your market. So innovation could be in any of the form. Then you have process innovation, which we have been discussing. Then we say, it is not always when we talk about innovation, a new product need to be developed. Like if I talk about the urban ladder, or I talk about the, Pepperfry, they are all what they are doing. They are making furnitures. Now, are they making something new? No. But as per the need, what they have done, they have customized their product. They have come up with some kind of modular kind of product. So it's like whenever there is a change, and that change according to something that can be served for the masses. So it is a product, or the way of development has changed, but that is again what? That is also your innovation. So innovation can be in any of the forms, process, product, services, or management, or financial innovations. So now whenever you have an idea, right? So what you should, the first phase is defined. So basically now what we are trying to see is, now we are trying to have a look at the design thinking process. So basically, as we started initially, we said, what is innovation? Innovation, we said, it is something, some kind of a systematic approach that you have, right? And your this systematic approach is what? You say, you first, there are five phases, right? You just emphasize. And what you define, ideate, prototype, and test. Now, even if your college has IIC, then I think some of your students, they must have participated in the hackathons, ideathon, or your twikathons. And in this, they are having these stages, right? They ask you to first submit your idea, right? And for that, what they do, they have an ideathon. Then what they do, they ask you to have a POC of your product. Then you have the next stage. Then they test your products, right? And again, if it is required, they ask you if you they find the product good. They further what they want, you need to polish your product. So what we are trying to say here, whenever you have an idea, you first need to start with what? You need to understand the needs, right? So in that, you need to define the problem. At a time, you should not try to attempt on multiple problems. You should just understand what that, okay, this is the pinpoint. Then try to look for what all things are contributing to that, and try to look for the solution for that. And accordingly, do what? You should try to make a product POC of that. That is product proof of concept you should make for that, right? You should test it. So initially, this is just the one cycle, right? Testing and developing a prototype. Now, if everything goes well, then again, you need to see, okay, this XY parameters are now satisfied. Again, you go back to the defined part. Try to include some more points into it. Again, try to make a prototype. And then you should try to see how you can extend it, or how you can have a broader vision of it, or something now that was just previously used for 5 patients can be applied now to 1,000. Like jo vaccine hui aapki, usko test kara. अब उसके बाद क्या हो रहा है, एज इट इज बिकमिंग सक्सेसफुल व्हाट इज हैपनिंग, यू आर नाउ ट्राइंग टू इंक्लूड कंपोनेंट्स इनटू इट एंड यू आर ट्राइंग टू अप्लाई टू योर डिफरेंट पेशेंट्स. सो सिमिलर थिंग्स वी आर ट्राइंग टू टॉक हियर. नाउ सी, नाउ समथिंग दैट इज इम्पोर्टेंट, यू ट्राई टू इनोवेट, राइट. एक हो सकता है कि ठीक है प्रॉब्लम है, इंडिया वुड हैव सेट बैक एंड सी लेट एंड फिर हैव वेट फॉर अदर प्लेयर्स टू मेक देयर वैक्सीन एंड व्हेन इट विल कम देन वी विल हैव अ वैक्सीन, अदरवाइज इट्स फाइन. द अदर अप्रोच वाज लाइक नो, वी डिड व्हाट, वी स्टार्टेड वर्किंग ऑन इट एंड एवरी टाइम मे बी सम ऑफ द इनिशियली देयर वाज सम काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम, देन वी सेड वी डिड व्हाट, देयर वर डिफरेंट कॉम्पिटिशंस दैट वी हैड इन द मार्केट्स. It is applicable to all products, right? So even if there is a failure, it's fine. We just need to rethink and we need to consider it as a first step for the innovation, right? So we accordingly we need to decide. ऐसा नहीं करना कि बीच में कुछ स्टार्ट करा, कुछ आधा गड़बड़ हुआ, बोर हो गए, now you are no more interested, so you again come up with a new idea and start working. No, you have to go from first step to your last step. That is the five phases that you have. And then you have to look at the viability for any of the product. And definitely, if it is you are able to develop it, then you need to see how you can contribute more to it, how you can have the revenue part into it, and again serve to other society and other affairs. And then again, don't just leave it. Don't just put it on the paperwork that you have carried out a sample of. Some disease that you were expecting, you said, okay, XYZ parameter, you did a study, you analyzed 100 students, you were able to have a good model for it. And then you have one paper, SCI index paper, you are satisfied, sit back. Please don't do that. Continue with your passion, work more for it and try to work more for the society. Okay. Now, let's see. This is again, now how well you are able to have your success, I'm talking in that terms, right? So now with this, I'll try to move to some of the things that we say for any of the innovation terms. We say it is easy, but we really need to think upon it. It's not that it's very hard, so we will just sit back and don't do anything about it. And the most important thing is transfer to a product. Now, this is the difficult part. We had idea, we know the parameters. Because of some kind of financial problems or something, we are not able to have a product out of it and we just leave it in between. No, please don't do that. Now, in order to support the ecosystem, lot of facilities we will just discuss have been provided by the government. And if successful, I know it's rare, but if it is there, then it is unique and it is sweet. Now, let's talk about, I hope, till this point, I am able to convey something to all of you. Is it okay till this point? Any one of you would like to ask anything? Otherwise, we'll move to the next section.
Ma'am, it was fine.
Okay. So let's talk about the innovation in India. So till now, I was just trying to tell you what is innovation and how visible innovation is different from invisible innovation. And a significant contributor to in the invisible innovation, but now we have like our vaccine has actually made us into the visible innovation also. And then we try to see what are the five steps for your design thinking process. And as a student, this is very important for you, those 5 points, because those 5 points will actually help you in development of any of the product and for different policies that are being supported by government. With those phases, you can even take a part there. So to promote innovation, there is a National Innovation Councils that you have. And this National Innovation Council is being supported or it has the back of different bank grants. Then you have grants from your CSI, different R&D centers. Then again, your private partners like FICCI, IMA, they are also contributing to it. And in total, what is happening at the state levels, you have secretarial innovation and experts. So all these are basically doing what, if you have an idea, the proof of concept is ready with you, you can give a presentation to these different funding agencies and they will support you. They will again help you to collaborate with the experts in different domains, and they will help you in development or taking your idea forward. Now, accumulation of technology capabilities, right? So there are different, you can say the public, private universities, education sectors, then you have R&Ds, even they help you with the labor availability. It means you are making any of the project, and suppose you have developed a kind of vaccine. Now you need to test it. So now with the help of the agencies, you will are getting the fund. The IPRs are given to you if your product has reached to a particular level. Government policies are there to aid you. So it's like it's your part now to come forward with an idea. And then a lot has been done. Lot of, like a seed fund. Mudra Bank is there. Atal Innovation is there. I'm naming all these initiatives which are being started by Government of India. They provide you with the seed fund for the activities. If someone want to have their own pathology center for something, some new kind of device that you have come up. So all these things are available to you as in students. You need to be aware of that. You need to collaborate with your faculty or your IAC self for these. And if you look at this slide, I hope you all understand what is a patent. I mean, if you do come up with some novel idea, then you can file a patent for that, right? So like you only have the right for that. Then no one else can have their rights for that. So in the, this is from 2018, the latest that is available on the internet. There is 68% rise in the patent application that is being filed by India as compared to the other countries. But when you look yourself globally, then if you see you have Bharat Electronics, TCS is filing, CSIR, and the maximum that is coming is from the IITs. But if you look here, another Chandigarh University has also filed so many patents. But when I look in a bigger picture, we have a long way to go. Like if you see here, though we have increased by 68%, but still you have a look at China, how many patents they have filed. And actually every day they come up, maybe it's a virus or it is something, they always have some innovative to do. But over in a global picture, we have a long way to go. But the good news here is we have increased by 68% as compared to what we used to do previously, right? So these are some of the companies who have been filing patents in different areas here. And you all should be aware of these things. Those who are students who want to have their startups, these policies are helping you. It's not just for the namesake. They actually provide you with the seed funds to start your work. And this is a 360 kind of an approach that you have. Now, this is where your IICs actually come into the picture. Like, as we talk about the five phases, right? So this is the first phase that I was talking about, the emphasize, right? You have your idea. You have the problem identification. Now, your college can identify the potential students, innovators and entrepreneurs from where? From your IIC networks, right? They will help them to, suppose they have come up with something, the corresponding field visits can be arranged for that. The college can, again, help them in making their problem statement more concrete by having the particular topic, like really a specific topic workshops. Design thinking process, like how students can have their proof of concept. Now those proof of concept, they can be validated now, whether they are working fine or not. Among them, it means they are something like a best project presentation or product or demo day can be kept. And out of that, the best POC can be picked. Then that can be applied from your organization for your IPRs. Now how IPRs are applied or patents are done, college can conduct the IPR session for that. Then your prototype is ready, that workshop on prototype design. Now how the product that a student has developed, a very raw product with some of the, maybe some hardboard, some Arduino kits, IoT components, you can help them in their making a product better each. And finally, one of the product they can be selected. And now from here, what we say, nominate best prototype, and it goes to your IIC portal. It means from your institutional circle, you are out to the next level, means now you are into the regional level mentoring, right? Now you are getting the experts from the industries, from the specific domains. You have the national level bootcamp. Your venture planning is there. They are providing you for the startup. Your hand holding is there, right? You are being allocated with fund. You have the experts, you have the seniors who are guiding you. And finally, you are coming up with the startups. So whichever domain it is IT, it is commerce, it is medical, this thing fits, holds good for everyone. So now the students have to come forward with their ideas, have trust on their IICs, have trust on their faculty, share your idea, discuss with them. They will be help guide you to come to the next level. Now, there are many sectors like energy sector, power sector, lot of sectors are there. Every day, what we are trying to do, what? Like we if you just talk about the hardware, network, accessibility, delivery, right? So what I am trying to say about all these things here. See, till now, what we have discussed, before I go into the healthcare part, the thing that discussed so far, innovation is different from Jugaad. Then innovation is something which has to be long-term and it can be done in on masses. Second, their innovation can be visible. Innovation can be invisible innovation. And as long as you talk about the novelty of the products and its distribution, it is fine whether it is visible or it is invisible. Then we talked about the design thinking process, which was a five-step process. And these five-step process, they are also supported by the IIC at the national level. And we have just now seen the process here, how you can move from your institutional circle to the national level circuit and start up with you can have your own startup. Now, innovation these days is in every sector, right? Everywhere the innovation is going on. Like if I try to talk about the innovation, like if in medical context, Hello, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Okay. So now innovation these days, it's like in energy sector, transport sector, power sector, health sector. But right now I'll just try to bring into your notice some of the innovations which are just related to the healthcare sector. Now, this line is very clear to all of us. Like now the care is shifting. It is not just restricted to hospital. The COVID has made us aware of that. It is like from homes, and finally, we can say it has become basically ubiquitous or pervasive in nature. And every time 24/7, the medical facilities are available to you. They are just a mobile call away from you. So every day we are trying to create better machines, right? Even if you just talk about the hearing aid, I could see just previously there used to be one big hearing aid. And there was a lot of disturbance in that with people who were not able to hear. They were not never interested in actually putting that hearing aid into their ears. But now you have such a fine and small pieces of the hearing aid that people are actually now they are using. I know I'm talking about that because I can see some of the elders who used to refuse previously. Now they are actually using those things. And everything here, now when I say it is pervasive or ubiquitous is there, it means something that is very important here is the network. Network plays all the things need to be connected here. They all have to be available all the time. So your clinic, your hospitals, your patients, everything need to be connected. And our telecom plays a major role here, the bandwidth or the kind of things that we need to make accessible to patient or the medical facilities. And then we have delivering medical requirements of the patient. Maybe if I need some medicine, I can just make a call or use one of the apps and that particular things are available to me. I can just make a video call to a doctor. I can just send the high quality or CT scan and everything. And the doctor on the other end can just see and just prescribe the medicine to me. So the buzzword these days, AI, robotics, big data, which otherwise, if we see, we will just think of these things with respect to the IT industry. But this is very well applicable. And the last year has shown us this thing that all these things, AI, robotics, big data, are having a great impact even in your healthcare sector. And government is providing with a lot of the electronic medical records that you have. Jitna aap data online ya aapka data collection electronically hota hai, usse aapko kya ho raha hai ki a lot of data is coming to you. Lot of data coming to you, it means in order to understand the problems of the future patients that you are having, this electronic data is actually helping you. So you have the records of thousands of your patient, that too with hundreds of parameter in that. So just imagine the size of data that you have created. And out of that data, now your AI comes into picture. Now what is happening? You are developing a model for that, right? You are developing a model. So you have a lot of images of the CT scans. Now from different angles and different XYZ parameter, you can understand better than me. But what is happening? Such a images, and whenever you have to make a study for a new patient. Now, since everything is available to you online, you can just in those models, you can just feed in the data and they will be helping you or basically assisting you in understanding the problem of the patient. And that can, even if the patient is in some rural place here, with the help of the mobile phones or teleconsulting, that person can also get the aid now. Now, these are just some of the examples which we have seen in the last year. Now, a lot of we have been using the international products for a long time, but the Startup India or Make in India mission has actually made healthcare technology also quite innovative, and ecosystem, the result of many innovations have come into light. One of the best example to quote at this time is the Bharat Biotech, right? The COVID co-vaccine, the India first engineers COVID-19 vaccine, which is at par with the Astra's and say Oxford Medicine. Then I gave you the example of Hindustan Syringe, which has captured 70% of the market. Similarly, you have the PharmaEasy, which is your India's largest healthcare delivery platform. So now you can see, now it is amalgamation of your health into the IT, into the big data, into your clouds, into your network, and all those things are contributing here. Now, we'll just try to have a look at the some of the initiative that Indian government, जो जैसे मैंने आपको अभी पीछे बताया था कि IPR है, design thinking process है, बहुत सारे आपके अटल योजना, seed funds, economics or your IMA organization are supported. And with that, I will just try to show you some of the innovations that have come up into the place recently. Like, I know you all are from the medical background, so you must be already aware of these things, but I would again like to just repeat the same for you. Rather, I will say that, like, you all are aware that there are many newborn babies, they are not able to breathe properly. So our very Indian company like SIB in New Delhi and Winmin Health, in collaboration, they have developed a product which is NeoBreathe, which is basically used to give a or you used to give breathe to the newborn babies. So it's just a small device which, instead of hand, it is foot operated. And this thing is had become really successful in saving life of thousands of your newborn babies, even in the rural areas. So this is again, for now, I'm just trying to talk right now about all the things from somewhere 2018 onwards, which have the latest innovation or which has come from the Indian companies. Then second, you have indigenous heart wall. This is from TTK Chitkara Value. They have TTK Chitkara. They have developed a wall, heart wall, which is not only less in price as compared to what we used to import. And it has been successful in about so many patients, the figure you can see, it is well planted into it, and again with a very low cost and developed in India. Then you have MIR CAM. Like this is again one of design that has been Cardiac Design Labs Private Limited from, I think it's from Chennai. They've come up with this real-time cardiac situation ambulance here, where the aid can be to any person who is a small town. And that too, again, IT comes into picture. A monitoring system is cloud-based and built in with the automatic workflow to report the incident to the doctors and cardiologists. So like basically what you have a device which is ambulatory ECG, where it and even you just had keep on supplying the data, patient or data to the doctor, and maybe it's in some remote place with the help of the cloud based feature, he is able to have the data, and the doctor can assist him right now. Similarly, another device that has been a medical device that has been developed by IIT Chennai. It is from the wearable category, and this is a device which is result of the 4 patent that was filed by your IIT Chennai, and finally they have come up with the CAPD for the dialysis anytime and anywhere. Now it is no longer necessary to carry the patient for the dialysis process to the hospitals or clinics. The next one, you have the cardiac patch, which is again from IIT Chennai and Nairomax Biotech Private Limited. They have again come up with a device, or I can say rather a patch, which is used to deal with the deformities in the heart. And it has been developed from the human and animal buffalo collagen tissues. And again, it is low cost, and it is something made up in our India only. Then you have defibrillators, again, developed again in the Indian market, and it runs both on the electricity as well as the handcrafted generators. Now, something like Cora stool management kit, again developed by Concert Medical from New Delhi. They have developed a kit which could carry these the stool in the orderless proof collection van. Then next you have neonatal rescuation trolley, which is again a product that you have from your Madras. It helps baby to easily intact placenta circulation, that is whenever the umbilical cord is yet to be cut. So what I'm trying to bring into your notice, that there are so many medical innovations that are taking place, and that are all these products that we are discussing. It is all your Indian products from your IITs, from some of the local companies that you have, the startup like NIMA Science. They have again customized for the managing road accident situation, hydrogel formation set from the biocompatible polymers. Similarly, you have a microscopic digital microscope, which is give you a magnified image of any of the medical images that you have, right? The medical images can be, you have so many, like there is a problem and I have a CT scan, and if I am using this, doctor is using a portable digital microscope. So even your x-rays or whatever your different the sheets are there for the analysis, they can be done in a digital way and for the examination, and it will help both doctor and the patient. Then you have your arsenic removal filters, and another one you have is your electrolyra. All these things, if you see, I'm just trying to talk about the Indian products only. The device is electronic operated speedjet used for after surgical to remove your larynx. It enables to help in the enhanced voice that you have. Then the last one, you have a innovative oximeter enrichment, which is again from your generic membrane from your Pune. This is a far cry ultra expanded oxygen therapy available. I can just name it, but being a doctor, I think you are better able to understand the utility of these products. And the proud moment for us is all these are within the last 2 to 3 years, they have been developed in our very own country. Now, at last, I would just like to mention about one latest tool, which has an about IBM Watson. Now, as I initially said, in 2003, 70% of the employees, they were your America based. But when the last data we saw in 2010, the data was like 70% we have from the India. So again, I said, I leave it to you, IBM, your Indian company, or it is your American company. But they have come up with a very good product, that is your IBM Watson. Now, this is basically, we have been seeing about, last few of the slides, we have been talking about many of the products. And all those products, since we say they can be used, many of the products we said that they can be used from anywhere and at any time. It means what I was trying to talk in all these products, that they all were digital. There was some kind of a digital transformation has taken place in the healthcare e-electronic devices, right? So if you want, I am sitting in Delhi and I want to have a consultation of some doctor in Pune without going there. So what I need to do, it has to be the digital kind of the e-clinic kind of a thing I have to have here. So your IBM Watson is supporting this, and it is doing this with the, again, with the help of AI data analytics tools. And again, the Manipal Hospital in India has collaborated with the IBM Watson to carry out the study of the cancer treatments. And it is a complete tool. It is actually, if you will search IBM Watson, you will see wonderful videos that you have for this IBM Watson, where they are showing you that how well they are able to connect with the patient. So like you just feed in the parameters of a particular patient, and AI is already there at the background. So you just need to give an information about the parameters for a particular patient, and the model will assist you in understanding the problem of that particular patient. So now the approach will become more patient-centric, rather than the doctor being always busy in doing the admin kind of a thing, just try to understand all the patient records, trying to check it. But now, since everything is online, automatically half of the part is done by the tool itself. Jaise ki ab aap agar kuch x-ray uske liye jate ho, to you must have seen that there is one platform that is available. So he is not preparing from the scratch. What does he do? He will just take the multiple snaps, and already the parameters are there in that window. So he's just trying to match what all parameters are there, and just finally trying to tell you that it is just a hairline, or it is you have completely lost your bone, or surgery is required, and so on. So basically what is happening, it is the approach has become more and more patient-centric, rather than a doctor spending a lot of time in just the routine administration. So this is the final submission from my side. Hope I am able to give some information to all of you. And in case anyone wants to ask, I am open to all the queries.
Thank you, ma'am. It was indeed a very delightful and thought-provoking session. So I'm pretty sure it is going to pave a pathway for budding innovators, and especially our budding doctors. And definitely today it has provided a lot of ideas in innovation in healthcare. Session is now open for any questions and answers. Any questions from the audience? Vaibhav, please end the session.